What is a database and why would you want to use one? I like to think of a database as a digital container for different types of resources. Libraries purchase subscriptions to databases just like they would purchase books for the shelves. These are high-quality resources with credible information that you would not be able to access just using the web. We are all undoubtedly very comfortable using Google, but did you know that if you have a specific citation to an article and you Google it, you'll most likely find a paywall when you locate the article on the web? You don't need to pay for articles. As a student, you have free access to our databases. Materials in the library databases aren't considered websites even though you are viewing them online. Materials within the databases can be periodical articles, ebooks, images, films, and more. We want you to learn how to use these resources because you will be expected to know how to find, navigate, and use them for quality resources as you progress through your life as a student. You can access the library's databases at any time or any place. You need to always start from the library's database page so that you can authenticate yourself as a Saddleback student. You just need to enter your student login information when prompted. We have many different kinds of databases that have different types of resources: newspapers, popular magazines, academic or scholarly journals. Others contain reference books like encyclopedias or ebooks in a specific academic field, and some house visual or audio materials like documentaries and films. Which database is right for you? Think about your topic and then think about the type of information you need. Maybe you are writing about something very current that just happened in the news. In this case, a newspaper article would be the best source. Newspapers are also great sources when you want to get local information or anecdotal stories or quotes from people affected by your topic. If you're looking for recent research on a topic or information on a very specific or narrow topic, you would want a scholarly article that was published within the last 5 years. Knowing what type of resource you need will help you narrow down your choice of which database suits your needs.
Our databases are organized into popular databases on the right side of the screen. In the center, you can see all of our databases listed alphabetically. The filters at the top of the screen let you find databases by subject, database type, and vendor. More often than not, we find that the popular databases suit most students' needs. If you're looking for a particular database associated with your class or topic, you can use the subject limiter to see the databases that are considered best bets. Here you can see what happens when I select environmental science. The best bets are highlighted in yellow, and additional options are listed below. What would I want to do if I wanted to see where I could find videos? First, I'd want to clear the current filters that I have. And then I could go to database type and select videos. From there, I can see the databases with videos listed along with a brief description.
Once you are comfortable searching one of our databases, you will find it easier to search the other databases too. The tips and tricks you will learn here in searching our databases can be applied to other databases as well. When in doubt, don't hesitate to ask a librarian for help in finding a database that suits your search.